It is a great honor and privilege for me to be here with you today to launch the debates of our Conference on Capability-Driven Defense Research and Innovation. We are most happy to host you here in Bucharest under the auspices of Romanian Presidency of European Union Council, together with our friends and partners from the European Defense Agency. Since the launching of the Global Strategy in 2016, the European Union has embraced a process aimed at fulfilling its level of ambition in the field of security and defense and focused its efforts on three strategic priorities: responding to external conflicts and crises, building partners' capacities, and protecting the European Union and its citizens. That was meant to enhance the Union's capacity to act as a security provider and its strategic autonomy, as well as to strengthen its ability to cooperate with partners and protect the citizens. In this context, defense research and innovation came rather soon to represent an area of work which individualizes the European action, having the prerequisite to play an essential role in contributing to European Union strategic autonomy. EDF, together with CARD and PESCO, are looking for the best solution for harmonizing processes in order to streamline defense planning at European level, providing the necessary support to member states in increasing the synchronization of national processes for endowing the armed forces and reducing fragmentation of the defense sector by strengthening the European defense technological and industrial base. In my view, European Defence Fund is one of the important and impact initiatives of the European Union defence package, alongside with the Coordinated Annual Review on Defence, CARD, and the Permanent Structured Cooperation, PESCO, aimed at addressing Europeans' current and future security and defence needs. As derived from the European Union Global Strategy and its implementation plan on security and defence,